Hey guys, Jake from 8.0 V10 Media here. Today we're doing a video on common problems and reliability issues with Dodge's 8.0 V10 Magnum engine. The 8.0 V10 Magnum was used from 1994 until 2003 as the gas alternative to the 5.9 Cummins 12 valve in the Ram 25 and 3500 HD trucks. It produced 310 horsepower and 450 torque, which was actually more than the 5.9 Cummins at the time produced. However, the Cummins got better gas mileage and it produced better low-end torque because it's a diesel, which made it better for towing. Additionally, the Magnum V10 also outproduced both its Ford and GM gas competitors of the time. So the Magnum was actually a very impressive engine for its time, and even today still puts out power numbers that are impressive and strong enough to continue to use these for daily driving and towing, even in today's standards. Now, there is a common misconception about the Magnum V10 used in HD trucks and the 8.0 V10 that was used in the Dodge Viper. They are both the same engine size, both V10s. However, the 8.0 Magnum and the engine that were used in the Viper were significantly different in design, so they are not the same engines. With that being said, let's go ahead and talk about common problems and reliability with these trucks. As we mentioned, they're extremely impressive from a performance standpoint, but now let's see if they hold up as well from a reliability standpoint. The first problem on our list is really more so not a problem, but it's with cracked cylinder heads. If you do researching around online, you will find a number of people and articles claiming that these trucks had issues with their cylinder heads cracking. There were a couple cases of this, but they were very few and far between to where we do not consider this to be a problem with these engines. It's not something that would cause us any concern with buying one or daily driving one or running one to high mileage. I just wanted to get in front of this and say that we don't think that cracked cylinder heads are a problem on this truck. The second problem is also not really a problem. Just something that's good to know is that these engines only get about 11 to 13 miles per gallon. Now, on an 8.0 V10 that's putting out as much power as that is, those are actually not too bad from a gas mileage standpoint. However, it is slightly less than what you're gonna be getting from a diesel engine at the time. Just a caveat that these things are gas guzzlers and a little bit more expensive to own from that standpoint. Now, the third problem on our list and getting into actual problems that these trucks have is engine hesitation. When some of these engines get older, there have been a lot of complaints that the engines would start to hesitate under acceleration, would have some rough idling, and various issues that were hard to pinpoint. The thought is that the issue is within the fueling system or with buildup in the valves from the EGR valve recirculating dirty gas into these engines. However, just running some seafoam or some valve cleaner tends to fix up this problem. And so it's not a very serious problem by any means, but it is something that tends to happen on these cars once they get above the 150 or 200,000 mile mark. The fourth thing is the fuel injectors. The fuel injectors on these engines are known to go bad somewhere around the 150,000 mile mark. Over the lifespan of these engines, you'll probably need to replace them at least once. The fuel injectors are prone to leaking and causing excess fuel to leak into the combustion chamber, which leads us into our fifth common problem, which is catalytic converter failure. When the injectors go bad and start to leak, that causes a lot of excess gas to be shot through the exhaust system. And then within the catalytic converter, that gas will go ahead and combust and essentially melt the internal components of the catalytic converter, causing it to get clogged up or causing it to completely hollow out. Six on our list is probably the most serious one or the most costly one out of all of the things here, and that's the transmission. These engines came with 47RE transmissions, and they don't really hold up too well on these engines over time. There are a lot of people that are on their third, fourth, or even fifth transmission on these vehicles just because they don't handle the power that these engines produce very well. Typically, if you're looking at taking these engines beyond 200,000 miles, that's probably about the point you're gonna need to look into getting a new transmission or getting your transmission rebuilt. There have been a number of people that have had worse luck and have had to replace these things every 100,000 miles. So just something to be cautious of, that the transmissions really are the weak points on these engines, and you're likely gonna run into transmission issues before you run into any serious engine problems. Seventh on our list is with the coolant thermostat. The thermostats on these are poorly designed, and for whatever reason, they like to fail very frequently. If you read through the comments on our blog post on this engine, there are a lot of people who say they're on their fourth or fifth thermostat. However, they're at the 300 plus thousand mile mark that they've run through that many. Just something to be aware of, that the thermostat can fail pretty frequently. Fortunately, it's a pretty inexpensive problem to have, but it's just one of the quirky problems that this engine has. Now, a couple other things that aren't quite as common but are noteworthy to mention is the ABS brake module does tend to fail on these things a little bit more commonly than on other vehicles, as well as the crankshaft position sensor. So that's it on our list of problems. When we look back on it, there are really few problems that are actual problems on here. We have the fuel injectors. When the fuel injectors go bad, they like to take out the catalytic converter, although that doesn't always happen. We've got issues with thermostat, and then some small sensor electronic related issues in the crank position sensor and the ABS module. And so all of those four problems are, I would say, relatively minor. Fuel injectors and catalytic converters can get expensive, but that typically only happens at very high mileage. We tend to consider that more of a maintenance problem at that point. Really, the only problem on this list that I would say is a true problem is just the strength of the transmissions. If you plan on driving one of these for a long time, just understand that the transmission's always gonna be something that's gonna need a little bit more maintenance and care than the rest of the engine. With that being said, there are tons of people who have taken these things beyond 300,000 miles. I will say, compared to the 5.9 Cummins 12 valve, the 8-liter Magnum is really no match when it comes to reliability and engine longevity. The Cummins 12 valve is widely considered the most reliable diesel ever produced, and those things chug past 500,000 miles easily. You're probably not quite gonna get there on the Magnum V10, but with that being said, there are tons of people, again, who have taken these, and people who have shared their experiences in the comments on our blog, who have taken these things well beyond 300,000 miles, and even someone who's made it up above 400,000 miles with very few problems. While I would say they don't quite compare to the Cummins, these are still extremely reliable engines, and they last a lot longer than, honestly, I would expect them to last, being an 8-liter V10. You know, that's a massive engine. It produces a good amount of power. Being able to get 300 plus thousand miles out of a gas engine like this is very impressive. So overall, while there are small problems here and you're going to run into higher maintenance costs once these things surpass the 150,000 mile mark, the block, the internals, the major engine components are all extremely strong and can easily run 300 plus thousand miles with proper maintenance. Anyways, guys, that wraps up things on our problems and reliability with the 8-liter Magnum V10. If you appreciated this content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for more Dodge and Ram content.